Good afternoon. Welcome to God's house as we worship and observe Christ the King Sunday. As we worship today, we'll worship under the theme, "The King is Coming." As we worship, we'll follow the order of service, service of word and sacrament. Let us begin our worship of our King with hymn 341, "Crown Him with Many Crowns." The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And also with you.
God invites us to come into his presence and worship him with humble and penitent hearts. Therefore, let us acknowledge our sinfulness and ask him to forgive us.
Holy and merciful Father, I confess that I am by nature sinful. That I have disobeyed you in my thoughts, words, and actions. I have done what is evil and failed to do what is good. For this I deserve your punishment, both now and in eternity. But I am truly sorry for my sins, and trusting in my Savior, Jesus Christ, I pray. Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner.
God, our Heavenly Father, has been merciful to us and has given us his one and only Son to be the atoning sacrifice for all of our sins. Therefore, as a called servant of Christ and by his authority, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. For all that we need in life, and for the wisdom to use all your gifts with gratitude and joy, hear our prayer, O Lord. For the steadfast assurance that nothing can separate us from your love, and for the courage to stand firm against the assaults of Satan and every evil, hear our prayer, O Christ. For the well-being of your holy church in all the world, and for those who offer here their worship and praise, hear our prayer, O Lord. Merciful God, maker and preserver of life, uphold us by your power and keep us in your tender care. The works of the Lord are great and glorious. His name is worthy of praise. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by your victory you have broken the power of the evil one. Fill our hearts with joy and peace as we look with hope to that day when every creature in heaven and on earth will acclaim you King of Kings and Lord of Lords to your unending praise and glory. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. You may be seated. Our first lesson today is taken from Daniel chapter 7. In my vision at night, I looked, and there before me was one like a son of man coming with the clouds of heaven. He approached the Ancient of Days and was led into his presence. He was given authority, glory, and sovereign power. All peoples, nations and men of every language worshipped him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that will not pass away. And his kingdom is one that will never be destroyed. This is the word of God. Our second lesson is taken from Revelation chapter 1. Grace and peace to you from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits before the throne, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, and has made us to be a kingdom of priests, to serve his God and Father. To him be glory, and power forever and ever. Amen. Look, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the peoples of the earth will mourn because of him. So shall it be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is, and who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. This is God's word. Alleluia. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Alleluia. Let us now take in an anthem from Martin Luther's choir that is entitled, Jesus is Lord. Please stand. The Gospel of our Lord according to John chapter 18. Pilate then went back inside the palace, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?" "Is that your own idea?" Jesus asked. "Or did others talk to you about me?" "Am I a Jew?" Pilate replied. "It was your people and your chief priests who handed you over to me. What is it you have done?" Jesus said, "My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jews. But now my kingdom is from another place." "You are a king then," said Pilate. Jesus answered, "You are right in saying I am a king. In fact, for this reason I was born. And for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. everyone on the side of truth listens to me. The Gospel of our Lord. You may be seated, and let's join in singing our hymn of the day, hymn 217, The Head That Once Was Crowned. Grace and peace to you from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits before the throne, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. My dear brother and sister in the Lord, would you like to play a game with me? Would you? All right, then let's play a game. Guess who or what? I want you to listen, and when it's done playing, I want you to tell me who or what is coming. Who's coming? Jaws. Yeah, my dad could sing that song as I was swimming back to the boat to make sure I would get there quicker. What about this one? Who's coming? Not Luke. Darth Vader. There you go. How about this one? What's about to happen? Ah, the Olympics. Very good. How about this one? Who's coming? Superman. There you go. All right, you're getting it. I think the people on Sunday might even like this one. What's going to happen? Football. That's right. One last one. One last one. Guess who or what's coming? The president. Isn't it amazing that we can take a look at all of those songs and we immediately know what's coming? We hear the song like, Hail to the Chief, and we know that we should see a picture of our president coming off of Air Force One and coming down the staircase, waving to the crowd as the band is playing. We know if we hear any of those songs, there's not much doubt in our mind what is coming. And in fact, for centuries, did you know that kings and queens have often been precluded with music? You would hear the trumpets and the bugles playing gorgeous music because the king or queen was entering the room. Make no mistake about it, as we sit here today and as we observe Christ the King Sunday, we will one day be sitting around and we will hear the trumpet call of God and we will see the Lord God Almighty, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, finally coming down in the clouds to come here to bring us to be with him forevermore. As we think about what our Lord God is telling us in this section of Scripture from Revelation, he is showing us that there is goodness for us to look forward to. In fact, he wants you and I to be ready so that we can exclaim, look, it's Christ, our King, the great I am, the everlasting God. As we take a look at those opening verses that I used as our invocation to this sermon, it is an introduction that the writer is using to exemplify who the Lord is, how the Lord, our King of Kings and Lord of Lords, manifests himself to us. In fact, oftentimes throughout the Old, as well as the New Testament, we would find how the Lord God would use different names to better comfort us to understand just who our Lord God is. And so as we hear the Lord God being introduced to us, it was from him who is, who was, and who is to come. If we were to sum up that phrase with two words, it would be simply, I am. The Lord God Almighty, of course, if you remember, revealed himself to Moses as I am. He told Moses to go and tell the people of Israel that I am has sent you. This has been and will continue to be a term or a title of God which proclaims to us that Christ our King had no beginning, he will have no end, and he will reign supreme forevermore. For there was never a time when he was not, and there will always be a time that he will be. For he is everlasting to everlasting. He is the great I am. As we think about what the great I am has done for us, our lesson actually puts in front of us all of his accolades. It says, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. The great I am is the faithful witness. What does that mean? To be a faithful witness means that he always represented his Father rightly and righteously in every way. He never once strayed to a path that would serve only himself, but he always was a faithful witness to what his Father has told him to do. And he is also the firstborn from the dead. It's not very often that we would think of a King of Kings and Lord of Lords being one who would have to die. But that's exactly what our Savior Jesus did. Our Christ came into this world that he would die and then be the very first one to ever, on his own fruition and by his own will, not allow death to hold him. And then lastly, he is known as the kings of, or the ruler of the kings of the earth. As we sit here today, I would imagine that there are a great number of things that may be bothering you. Maybe it is the way things are or are not being dealt with in Washington, D.C. Maybe what is bothering you is just what is happening in our country, how things are going. Maybe it is the concern that you might have for yourself and the health issues that you might be going through. Or it may be the health issues that a loved one has you quite concerned. Whatever it might be, whatever might be challenging you or bothering you, is it not safe to say that all of our efforts on our own seem to always fall flat? We sometimes would like to think, if I just did something more, things would be better. If I would just try harder, things would get better. And yet, time and time again, effort after effort, we find ourselves in the same spot, that we are powerless and that we need to relinquish our power to the great I Am, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Christ, the one who is in control of all of these things. And yet, maybe that's where our main troubles lie. It lies in the fact that he has everything under control, and that frustrates us. Because we see how things go in this life, and it frustrates us because we see never things going the way we thought they should go. Recoveries from surgeries and illnesses either take far too long or we never fully recover. We see our friends and our loved ones going through all sorts of great pains and struggles. We hear of dear loved ones who are being taken to God's side because of illness. And I would say that it bothers us or it frustrates us because we say things like, how can a loving God allow, fill in the blank. This is one of those questions that as we approach the great Lord God, the great I Am, we struggle with. And it frustrates us because the Lord is not bothered by the bump in the road because that was there for his good purpose. He's not bothered by a prognosis of a terminal illness that's going to bring you to his side, for that is how he is going to bring you close to his side. But maybe that's what bothers us even more then. Is because we begin to realize that even with all of the bumps in the roads and the difficulties that we face and the sicknesses and the illnesses and how we're not in control, then all of a sudden that means someone else is. And I don't like that. I like being in control. I like thinking that I have things that I can manage. That if I would do one thing, then another thing either in a positive way would happen. I like that. But that's just not the case when it comes to life, is it? It's not the case at all. And we find ourselves in a very weak and compromising position. We find ourselves in a position where we realize that we need help and that we realize that all of a sudden our greatest nemesis is what stares back at us when we look in the mirror. We are not the king. Christ is our King. It's a good thing he is, though. Because if you would look at how he exercises his authority versus how we would exercise ours, he did so selflessly where we would very likely have done so selfishly. And the Lord God shows us just how he has exercised his authority, and that is so that he could rescue you and me from the dreads of sin. You see, when he came into this world, it was not to the trumpet calls of that of a king. It was in a humble and lowly state. He came to the choir of an angels, but who did they sing to but none other than the lowly shepherds who were out in the fields nearby. And here our King of Kings and Lord of Lords laid and swaddled in a manger, in a lowly state, with his mother nearby, with cows mooing and cattle lowing. There was our King. And he came into this world so that he could accomplish something as the great I Am, the one who has always been, so that you and I could be with him always. See, the Lord God knew we struggle. He knew we would be bothered, and he knew that we would be frustrated. And you know how he knew that? Because Adam and Eve struggled that same problem, that they weren't in control. They wanted control, and they didn't have it. And so the Lord knew. The Lord knew exactly what he had to do to rescue us from our sins. And so he reminds us, when we are down and when we are depressed or when we are frustrated, he shows us that the great I Am, with his nail-pierced hands, he lifts us up and he forgives us of our sins. And he shows us that his death on the cross as the firstborn from the dead was in order to buy and purchase for you a victory over sin, over death, and even over the devil himself. This victory of Christ our King is a victory that has for us this joy and reality that we cannot wait for him to come again. In fact, the Lord God in our lesson says, "To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood and has made us to be a kingdom and priests to serve his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen." Our Lord God, he shows us that is our King. Our King is the one who shed his blood for us and has made us a kingdom for himself, that he has rescued us and made us his own. The great I Am did that for you. The one who was promised from long ago has come so that he could rescue us. Yes, sir, this is our King. The one who has come to rescue us. And he is not just the great I Am, but he is the everlasting God. Look, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. And the peoples of the earth will mourn because of him. So shall it be. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. As we look at our everlasting God, the great comfort of this is knowing that there will be no end to our joy and the reign of our King. We're not going to have to worry about a change of scene or a change of party. For Christ our King will reign forever. We won't have to worry if there's a blue wave or a red wave or any other kind of wave. For Christ is our King. And it's not for a matter of years, but it is for a matter of eternity. And so that has every Christian ready to exclaim, "Look, he is coming with the clouds." And we are going to hear that trumpet call of God. And we will know Christ is coming. He is coming to rescue us and bring us forevermore to his side. He has come to reunite my body and soul forevermore. He is coming. And so when we hear the trumpet call of God, Yes, indeed. We will be joy-filled and exclaiming, look, it's Christ our King. Amen. Please stand. And now may the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, guard and keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Join with me in confessing our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became fully human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who in unity with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Christian apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In our special prayers today, we keep Ryan Yeager in our prayers. We called Ryan Yeager to be our next principal here at St. Paul's. We also pray for John and Karen Hupke, who are celebrating their 58th wedding anniversary, Earl and Judy Roy, who are celebrating their 60th wedding anniversary, and Dale and Mary Zillish, who are celebrating their 57th wedding anniversary. And so we give thanks to the Lord for these three families, for all of God's blessings throughout the many years of their married life. Let us join together in the responsive prayer of the church for Christ the King Sunday. We pray. To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever.
Let us rejoice and be glad and give him glory.
You are worthy, O Christ our King, to receive honor and glory and praise, for you created all things, and by your will they were created and have their being.
Alleluia, for our Lord God Almighty reigns.
You are worthy, O Christ our King, to receive honor and glory and praise, because you were slain, and with your blood you purchased us for God. From every tribe, language, and people and nation, you have called us into your kingdom and have made us priests to serve you, our God and Father.
Help us live as royal priests.
We give you thanks, O Christ, our Shepherd King, because you have searched for us and have found us. Lead us to the green pastures and quiet waters of your saving love, so that we may enjoy peace and comfort for our souls.
Heal our hearts when they are broken with sin and guilt. Strengthen us when we are weak.
We give thanks to you, O Lord, Lord God Almighty, because you have taken your great power and have begun to reign. Come with your mighty power to break and defeat every evil plan and purpose of the devil, of the ungodly influences and ideas of the world, and of our own sinful nature. Use your power to calm the unrest among nations and peoples, so that your kingdom may spread and grow.
Strengthen our confidence in knowing that your kingdom will never be destroyed.
O Christ, our King, you have supremacy over all. You will judge the world in righteousness and the peoples with equity. You have destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Reign in our hearts, that we may serve you more faithfully and speak more boldly to others of your saving love.
Praise be to the Lord God.
may the whole earth be filled with his glory.
Lord God Almighty, we come before you with thanks for the 58 years that you have blessed John and Karen Hupke, for the 57 years that you have blessed Dale and Mary Zillish, and for the 6 years that you have blessed Earl and Judy Roy. With these three couples, we give you thanks for the many years that you have blessed them, and that we ask that you would continue to shower them with your grace and your mercy, your compassion and your love for the many years that they have together to come. We ask that you would continue to foster in them a love that you display throughout your word, a love that is selfless and not self-seeking. We ask that you would also help each of these couples rest their cares and worries upon you, their good and gracious God. Also, dear Lord, we ask that you would continue to bless the deliberations of Mr. Ryan Yeager, whom we have called to serve as our next principal. Through this time, we ask that you would bless both St. Paul's as well as St. John's and Two Rivers, and we ask that your will be done and that Mr. Yeager may find confidence in the peace and in the confidence and peace in the decision that he makes. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus our Lord, and now ask you to hear us as we bring you our private petitions. Look, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. The kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Christ, and he will reign forever and ever, King of kings and Lord of lords.
The Lord God Almighty reigns. Let us rejoice and be glad and give him glory. Amen.
We also join together to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
Praise to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In love he has blessed us with every spiritual blessing. He protects and preserves his church in every age and gives us confidence to lift up our heads and watch for Jesus with joy. Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ. To him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and thanks and honor and glory forever and ever. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body, which is given for you. do this in remembrance of me. And then he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this whenever you drink it, in remembrance of me. The peace of the Lord be with you always. The Lord's Supper is prepared. I invite those who are confirmed members to come forward and partake of this blessing that is prepared. Please stand and join with me in the song of thanksgiving. Hear the prayer of your people, O Lord, that the lips which have praised you here may glorify you in the world, that the eyes which have seen the coming of your Son may long for his coming again, and that all who have received in his true body and blood the pledge of your forgiveness may be restored to live a new and holy life through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Brothers and sisters, go in peace, live in harmony with one another, and serve the Lord with gladness. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Please be seated as we join in singing hymn 704, Lo, He Comes with Clouds Descending.
Thank you.
Well, good afternoon again and welcome. A wonderful opportunity for us to hear all about our King, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And thank you for playing that game with me. That was quite enjoyable for me as well. There are a couple of housekeeping notes, and that is in lieu of the holidays that are upcoming. So I want you to please take a look and make note of the fact that we will be having only a 6:30 evening service on Wednesday next week. That Wednesday evening service will also coincide with our celebration of 160 years as a congregation. Back in 1861, St. Paul's began. And so we celebrate and give thanks to the Lord for all he has done. And the service and everything else centers on giving thanks for our ancestors who have brought forth the wisdom in starting this church and giving thanks to you for continuing it and asking the Lord to bless it for years to come. So please come and enjoy that. And if you would like, because you are busy human beings, as most are, come and join us for food first. It's going to be a wonderful meal. We'll have turkey. We'll have stuffing and potatoes and corn and gravy and whatever else that you would like. And you are more than welcome to attend. It starts at 5 p.m. and it will go all the way up to the start of the service. And I will promise I won't be dull, so you will not fall asleep with the tryptophan going through your veins. The turkey will just help you relax and take in the songs of thanksgiving that we'll have that evening. Or maybe you just need to coincide the turkey with a few pieces of pie that will kind of, you know, sugar you up before service. Other than that, as you heard in our prayers, Mr. Ryan Yeager continues to deliberate the call that we have administered to him for our principal. We are also having a pre-call meeting this evening following worship in the second service. So if you would like to put in some input or at least hear what the input has been so far, our district president will be here tonight, Pastor Michael Jensen, and he will certainly be serving us and helping us as we forge forward and looking for a new individual to serve as our pastor here at St. Paul's along with me. And so, that is happening tonight. So if you have nothing going on at 7:30, which, you know, maybe you don't, you can come back here and come join us for the open forum, which will be in the church fellowship hall. All are invited to attend. Aside from that, I believe that's all. This coming Sunday, please keep in your prayers, Mrs. Kelly Otterstadter now. She has been slowly but surely getting acclimated to our school. She has been here for the last couple of days observing as well as learning the routines, and her first day as a teacher will be this coming Monday. And so we'll be having a box out for her as we can shower her with gifts. She is coming from Watertown, so maybe gas cards might be a gift that she will appreciate and use often. So just some different thoughts. Other than that, I think I've talked enough.